turn around this instant. You are carrying the shadow with you.
9th of August, 1839. I can't stop sweating and shaking. The warding ritual was not something of a sane mind. I did not even realize the dungeon was still in use. Alexander had his servants bring one of the prisoners, a murderer, he told me. Alexander made all the arrangements, but he said I had to perform the ritual in order to have the right effect. The shadow could be led astray by the blood of another. Killing the man would provide us precious time. What else could I do? Alexander said it had to be done. He is saving my life. I don't have the luxury of argument.
Agrippa, I need you to stay awake. Can you feel the syringe?
No, I can't feel anything. Alexander?
Yes?
Soon, I won't even be able to move, will I?
Your life is safe.
I don't doubt that. But will it be worth living? my gratitude. My name is Agrippa. Whom are you?
Daniel?
Like the prophet thrown into the lion's den? Tell me, are you among the lions, Daniel? You want to stop Alexander? Oh my, so Babylon shall fall, you say. You hurry too much. Alexander is toothless without an awl. He has one. That's not very promising at all. The sanctum is basically impenetrable, but guess why more. It could be breached by another, but Alexander broke his, I mean, my oath, a long time ago. Really? Well, if you tell the truth, by all means, seek out the pieces of the broken oath and mend away. I believe he uses them for torture now. They practically leak madness, which is quite useful, I understand. There should be six of them. Look around the choir and the transept. You should be able to find them there. Taking me with you? I know it sounds ridiculous. I mean, look at him. But if you find anything concerning a man named Johann Ryan, would you please bring it to me? I believe he was working on a way to help me. A recipe for some sort of potion. A tonic to free me from this husk of mine. So many of Alexander's things are breaking down. Look around. Maybe the other room. There are machine parts hidden all over this place. You'll find a way to fix it.
To me, I'm Heinrich Cornelius Agrippa. I was once quite important to you. Baron Alexander has sustained my soul in this dead husk for years. Who knows how many? Hundreds, I presume.
Impressive in many ways, but he has grown impatient. Thank you.
I know this. I've been here already. I know this taste. The taste of Damascus rose obfuscating the truth in a dim haze. They may sweep the traces from my memory, but my body remembers. These cuts speak volumes, even though my mind remains silent. They will be back. Oh, they will be back.
Descending into the underworld.
Are you hiding something?
What do you mean?
Never mind. Your intuition is remarkable.
I'm not sure I'm following.
It doesn't matter. It's just a myth after all.
Thank you.
of August, 1839. The banishment ritual is taking longer than expected, and we have to do what is needed. I spend my time helping out the prisoners. Being around these degenerates makes me ill. None of them even tries to face their punishment with any kind of dignity. They taunt me with their lies of innocence and their cowardly pleas of mercy. What can make a man fall so far from the grace of a civilized existence? They are all wicked men, and I remind myself of it constantly. Still, I am thankful for God sending these monsters our way, as they will serve as the instruments of my salvation. I try to study the different tools in the torture chamber and learn how to use them effectively. Last time was messy, and the effect suffered from my inexperience. When the next warding is to be performed, I shall be ready.
Are meant to hold prisoners who are under treatment. The people you send for will end up here. Remember that the confinement itself works as a preamble to the torture, and you should pace yourself. Don't take anyone before they are ready.
Understood.
Sounds from the torture chambers are shuttled in through those pipes in the ceiling. Manage your victims well, and let one prisoner's pain instill terror in his cellmate.
There's something else. I'm the next best thing.
Alexander really valued it. None other than Johann Reyer. You never heard of Johann Reyer? My God, boy. He's probably the greatest man in history. And you don't know him? Or is it the world who has forgotten him? Reyer was my pupil. My pupil. Yes, I do take pride in that matter. Is it so wrong? I found a Mithraea once, one which had not been plundered. Do you know Mithraeuses? I suppose it doesn't matter. It is an old thing, building temples out of caverns. The Dark World being the universe, and inside are its followers. Humans watching the sky flowing.
Get her back!
you get it.
Not many orbs are left. They sometimes consume themselves, or break, then used by an unknown. I was lucky. The orb I found spared my life and returned to where I found it. I know because Alexander took it and brought it to Brandenburg. Vile is a brave man and dared to proceed that I did not. He unearthed a number of cavern temples and gathered a whole collection of orbs. But, unlike every other finder since the fall of the slavery, he was able to unshackle the horror you and I connected with the orbs. He used them and was able to travel far and wide, beyond the world itself.
Me, powerful?
Not so very. I've done all that I can to escape this prison. But now, I use all my strength merely to stay alive. My pupil, Johann Bayer, said he found a way to take me with him beyond the stars. But I was too afraid to come along. Seriously. And now, all I can do is regret it. I've always hoped Fire would return and give me a second chance. But so does Alexander. That's why he keeps me here, as a hostage, hoping Fire will reveal himself. You're a good boy, Tanya. And I appreciate your company. But I believe you have more important things to take care of. You should hurry, Tanya. No time for sitting around. You're a good boy, Tanya. And I appreciate your company. But I believe you have more important things to take care of. You should hurry, Daniel. No time for sitting around. You're a good boy, Daniel. And I appreciate your company. But I believe you have more important things to take care of. You should hurry, Daniel. No time for sitting around. You're a good boy, Daniel. And I appreciate your company. But I believe you have more important things to take care of. You should hurry, Daniel. No time for sitting around. You're a good boy, Tanya. And I appreciate your company. But I believe you have more important things to take care of.